Konnichiwa, KemushiChan, they're not Loretta this. Welcome back to the hidden, beautiful countryside vibes of Tokyo that you never knew were in Tokyo. Last time we were in Shibamata. But today we are in a new part of the Katsushika area, which is full of beautiful nature, rivers, distant trains going by, and a slower pace than you might be used to in the city. As you can see behind me, I have another trusty bike buddy. And unlike before, this one is all manual. I'm going to be doing it by my own power today. This bike was actually rented by the rental cycle center up the hill over there that you can rent only on the weekends. But there are lots of places around the area, including a cool hostel that I'll show you later, where you can rent bikes and kind of get really deep into the countryside vibes. So enough chit chat. Let's go. I'm standing out here in the middle of the Edo River. You know that funny joke that's like, how do you say I went to Tokyo in past tense? And somebody writes, I went to Edo. I feel like this is completely where we are today. Today we are standing on the edge of Tokyo. Behind me is actually the very last piece before the Edo River. And all the way over here now is Chiba. This is the pier where you ride for the Yagiri no Watashi, which is a completely retro original service that was handed down over years that they're actually still doing here, where the only job is literally just to ferry people across from Edo, from Tokyo, over to the other side to Chiba. Yagiri no Watashi. There's our man now.
Konnichiwa.
これ難しいですか?うん、まあこれ難しい顔してるだけで本当は簡単なんだよね。電車通ってるぐらいですね。このギシギシ言ってる音がね、信号と100線で選ばれちゃったんですね。素敵です。
江戸時代の初期ね、今から400年ぐらい前に国境だったんですよね、江戸川がね。それで関所を渡んなきゃいけなかったんですね、水戸街道の金町の関所っていうところ。そこを渡んないでもいいように、農民の方だけが、お百姓さんだけが、自由に渡し船が使えたっていうところ。そこが江戸川には15箇所ぐらいありまして、その中の一つが矢切の渡しですね。
当時の例えば料金とかはありましたか?いや、私の子供の頃は10円って時がありましたね。
10円から20円。もしかしてトラさんのそのキャラクターがもう100円ぐらいとかしましたかな?
トラさんの映画で見てるとね、30円ってのね、映画の中出てくると思いますからね。
じゃあありがとうございました。はい、どうもありがとうございました。
Hey guys, you ready for a little cycle break? I found a nice little spot here in the woods, so I figured we could take a little break. So in my last video, you may have seen, but I actually picked up some snacks from the Haikara Yokocho like retro store, and they had some candy. So I kind of got some dagashi snacks. This one's pudding. Poochie pudding! And a little drink for the road. This one, it's a mini cola, or at least it looks like it, but it's actually a candy. And a sembe, soul sembe, which I'm pretty sure I've crushed by now. Oh no. Let's just sit back, enjoy the view, and have a snack. All right, here we go. The retro flavor. This may be retro candy, but the flavor is still fresh. You can see. Can you see that? Shomi kigen. Still safe. Only retro in spirit. You're completely broken. It's okay. The flavor is still there, I'm sure. Sauce. Acquired. It's like an ice cream cone flavor from the actual cracker, but the sauce tastes like yakisoba. Umai na, umai na, it says. I agree. This sauce is addicting. The sembe are vehicles for flavor. Puchi pudding. Bite size. Oh. Ah. Ooh, here we go. Oh. It's really pudding. Can you see the jiggle 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 jiggle? Oh my gosh, that's really good. Why did I eat it so fast? It's gone. It's so good. Lip smacking good. It's supposed to be pudding flavor, but it tastes like a coconut, caramel, vanilla, yum. Let's wash it all down with some Coke. Yeah. So you may have heard from the various sounds around me, but there are people playing music, people walking their dogs, people having picnics. Where we are here in the middle of Mizumoto Park is a huge, wide open space where you can pretty much do any kind of recreation. But there's also these beautiful trees when you ride through here on a bike or just walk through. When I came in here, I almost forgot I was in Japan. When you cycle in and walk past the first kind of body of water, you immediately are hit by this wonderful, earthy, mulchy bark, fresh smell. Hey guys, welcome back. Welcome to Tateishi. This is a different area that still has the same retro vibe, literally a different taste that you can enjoy all night long. For nightlife and after hours, this is where you want to be if you want retro, real, old school Japan with great flavor. I have a special place to show you. Let's go check it out.
なぜトマトおでん、はい、これ本当のこと言っていいんですか。<笑>お願いします。普通にテレビを見てて、おでん屋さんでトマトを出してるよっていうのを見たんですよ。親もおでんの種とかテイクアウェイのお店やってるんで、はい、でなんかお出汁がそれぞれ違うじゃないですか、お店ごとに。はい、まあ、うちでそういうのやってもいいのかなというか、どうなるかなっていうところから出してみたら、 まあ、好評というか。
これから海外からのお客様来られるようになったら、はい、絶対になんか出したいメニューとか味わってみたいメニューとかありますか。
おでん、うん、をなんか食べてみてもらいたいなみたいな。 そこで、っていう人もいるかもしれないし、まあ、リアルなそこら辺を出したいですね。
That's it for my adventure here in Tateishi. In the past two videos, we got to taste a whole different flair to the city, which wasn't really city at all. There's delicious food and really nice people who made my visit here absolutely amazing. It's really convenient on the Keisei lines if you're on your way to Narita, if you're coming from Haneda, but more importantly, if you want to stay and enjoy the vibes, enjoy some of the nightlife, there is a new hostel that opened up just a couple years back that has a really cool vibe to it.Checked it out and they have very modern, branded, cool rooms that you can stay in. And on the fourth floor, there are artist rooms that were designed by Japanese and foreign artists who came together to kind of put together the Shibamata art feel and vibe into different room concepts. The manager is super nice. And from what I saw, there is a whole host of people coming from across the world. The place where I rented a bike today is usually open on the weekends. But if you stay at the actual hostel, then you can rent the bikes there, get around and kind of enjoy not just Shibamata, but the area around the park and everywhere around as well. I'll leave some information below in a link if you want to check it out. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. 今日もご視聴ありがとうございました. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.